We have a detention center in my region in Washington State, the Northwest Detention Center in Tacoma. I understand it currently in the middle of negotiating the terms of a contract, and it's had to be extended, negotiations have had to be extended twice now. The firm deadline to wrap up is now the 23rd of this month, is my understanding. There's been very little transparency in these negotiations. According to some estimates, American taxpayers are on the hook for $300 a day per detainee, with all that money going to private prison companies. So why is there so little transparency in the negotiations like this that are taking place across the country? And are you doing anything to open up the process so we can see what's happening?
I'm not familiar exactly with that. I can certainly give you some more background after this hearing with respect to that particular negotiation. But no, we do want to have transparency. There are parties to a negotiation, and usually it's up to those parties to come up with the final terms. But I will tell you that we do seek, through all our meetings with all of our stakeholders, whether they're in law enforcement or non-governmental organizations or others, their views on how things can be improved. And I certainly am intending to, I hope I can get out there, but I want to get out to more facilities to make sure, and I think we've communicated pretty clearly to folks that are doing those negotiations, to make sure that we're doing them in the way that ensures security, but also humane treatment of individuals, whether they're documented or not.
If you have other information that you're able to give me, I'd greatly appreciate it. And if you're able to come out to Washington State and visit the facility, we'd appreciate that too.
Thank you,
so
ma'am.
That you can have that direct experience.
I'd actually like to do that.
As a follow-up, there was an October 2014 GAO report that I requested with a number of colleagues, identified three areas where ICE is falling short in tracking and managing detention costs and expenditures. The three areas were: one, collecting and maintaining cost data; two, ensuring cost is considered in placing aliens in detention facilities; and three, preventing improper payments to detention facility operators. So do you agree that there are improvements that can be made in this area? And if so, what steps are being taken to improve?
I always think that we can be more efficient. I've preached that since I've joined the agency, that we need to look for efficiencies because, as we well know, funds are not guaranteed from year to year, as we've experienced firsthand at the department. But no, we are looking at all of those things. We're looking at to make sure that costs are allocated properly. We've got staff that has been trained in order to look for that specifically. And we do periodic audits of those contracts. And I'm not familiar with the report you're speaking of. I would like to read it also to make sure that we've addressed those areas you've identified.
Okay, and if we can follow up on that too, I'd also
Thank you. Appreciate that.
There are a number of counties in my state and Washington, including King County, our largest county, that have formally adopted policies to ignore certain ICE detainer requests. And so I know you've talked about this a bit before, but I was wondering if you could explain your views regarding whether states and localities should be forced to comply with ICE detainers.
We are in the middle, as you know, as I indicated earlier, of a cross-country tour of those area of those jurisdictions that have refused to work with us. We are trying to assure people we're looking at priority enforcement, not just general undocumented immigrant enforcement. We're looking at requests. We're not asking anyone to detain someone, as we did before, beyond the term of their local jurisdiction sentence. We are working to identify the areas we can all agree on: murderers, the sexual assaulters, those folks that present a danger to the community based on all the first facts and circumstances pertaining to a case. So it's a challenging job, and presents opportunities for us to visit with our local and state officials, and not only them, but non-governmental organizations, to help us allay their fears and assure them that PEP is different PEP is different, and we're trying to work with communities to do it in the best way for that specific community.
The gentlelady's time has expired.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chair.